Hey guys, it's Frazer Caswell from Mwave, and today we're going to be building this budget gaming PC. At the time of recording, it costs just under $1,000 Australian, and it's capable of medium to high gaming at 1080p. We will also talk about why we chose certain parts inside today's build and show you how we put them all together. Here are all the parts we'll be using today. Okay, so without further ado, let's get into the build. When I'm building a new PC, I always like to prep the motherboard from outside the case because it's a lot easier to get your hands around it. The motherboard we're using today is the ASRock H410M HDV. The reason I picked this is because it has all the support we need for the components we're using. It has the two RAM slots for the two RAM, and we have an LGA 1200 socket which supports 10th gen Intel, and of course, we're using an i3-10100F. When installing the CPU into the motherboard, the first thing I do is grab the retention arm, pull it to the side and lift it up, and I just bring the cover up with it. And then I grab the CPU out of the box, out of the case. And I make sure to grab it from its sides and not underneath where the gold contacts are, because you don't want to dirty those up. And then you're going to look on the actual front of the processor and look for a triangle. So the triangle's here. And then you're going to identify where the triangle is on the black cover, which is here. When the triangles are lined up, you can just gently lower the processor into the socket. So yeah, once it's in like that, it's nice and firm and it's sitting correctly, you can lower back down the cover and it should slip under this screw here. And then just push the retention bracket. There is a little bit of pressure and you'll feel it. And as you push it down, the cover will pop off. Done. So that's the CPU installed. Now I'm going to install the cooler. We got a nice easy one today, just the stock cooler. And you'll notice on the bottom of it, it has thermal paste pre-applied in the factory. So that's really convenient because we won't need to actually apply our own. So what I do is I check that this Intel is facing the right way upright. And then I place so that these little white feet will go into the four holes around the CPU socket. So once you've aligned these 4 feet up into the holes, you can just gently lower down the cooler. It can be slightly fiddly, but it shouldn't be too difficult. And then all I do is just push down on each of these. I do alternate, so I go here across diagonally. So once it's installed, you can pick it up by the heatsink and turn it over. And you can just check that these little black nibs have come through all of the feet. And this just ensures that yes, the stock cooler is installed correctly and you have proper thermal transfer between the CPU heatsink and the actual stock cooler heatsink. So now you can install the fan cable. Here we go. So look for the CPU fan connection on your motherboard. It's usually up the top here. So I have CPU fan 1 and I have a water pump. So obviously I'm going to pick CPU fan and then just plug it in. And just make sure that the cable's not in the way of the fan. Now with the CPU installed, I usually install the RAM. The RAM I'm using is the PMY Accelerate. And I didn't want to settle for just 8 gigs because some games nowadays are quite memory hungry. So I've got 16 gigs of RAM. When I'm installing the RAM, first thing I want to do is just make sure that the notch on the RAM itself aligns with the notch on the motherboard slot. And then I just gently insert it. And then you'll notice that it's not pushed in all the way because you actually have to give it quite a push down. I push down on either end usually, until it clicks in. And then you can check it visually from the side if you want that it's actually in place. But, and then basically just repeat it for the second stick. Okay, so with the motherboard all prepared and ready to go, I wanna start preparing the case. For the case, I'm using the Antec DP301M. It's a compact little case, which is ideal for our Micro-ATX motherboard. And it's really good value for money. Personally, I think it looks great as well. Okay, so just to take off the glass, you just take out these 4 screws. All right. Then I'm just gonna remove the other side panel. so we can get access to that part of the case. And that just slides off. Okay, so that's the case all opened up. You just want to take off the cables on the rear. There's a couple of twist ties here, so you can just undo that. First thing I always do when building in a new case is I make sure that these standoffs are located in the correct position for my motherboard. So usually you can check there's a indicator on the actual tray. Here it says M is for Micro-ATX and I is for Mini-ATX. So basically all I've got to do is make sure that for M, for Micro-ATX, which is our motherboard, that there's a standoff in each of them. So we have them all here. Now that I've got my four screws ready and I can install the motherboard because the standoffs are correct, I just want to make sure that I install the backplate first. Some motherboards have the backplate included attached to them, but this particular one doesn't. Then you're just going to flip it so it faces outside and then bring it to the back of the case and align it with that big slot. And then you just push it in. So that's it in place now. So now with the I/O plate installed, I'm going to install the motherboard into the case. Remember, you'll be doing this on its back, so the way I'm doing it's a little bit tricky, but I want to show you what I'm doing. Essentially, I'm going to line up these ports with the back I/O plate. All right, now they're all lined up. I'm just checking my standoffs are lined up as well. Then I'm just going to try and hold it in place and screw it in. So now with the motherboard installed, I'm going to connect the front panel cables. So that's our USBs and audio jacks. So on this particular motherboard, we've got a fan header for a chassis fan just beside the CPU fan header. So I'll just plug straight into there. So that's that one there. Next, I'm just going to install the USB 3 cable. So that's here on the right hand side of the motherboard. Now I'm going to install the HD audio cable. Bring it up. You'll notice there's one blank connection, so that tells you the orientation. So you just have to look at it. It's a little bit hard for you guys to see, but it's here and I can base my orientation on the way it looks. So that's plugged in there. And now I'm going to connect the front panel headers, which is, these are the most common connections that slip people up. So we've got power switch, reset switch, and hard drive LED. So you have this connection here. If this motherboard doesn't actually show you how this connection layout goes, so you can check the motherboard manual to figure it out. So power switch goes here. Reset switch generally is under the power switch and hard drive LED. With all those cables connected to the motherboard, the next thing I'm going to install is the power supply. For the power supply, I'm using the Thermaltake Smart RGB 500 watt. So some cases, the power supply will install from the rear side here or from here. So all we have to do is just make sure that the fan is facing down because that's where the grill is. And then slide it in. And then I just make sure that the power supply is lined up with the screw holes. Connect it, screw it in. Okay. So now that the power supply is mounted, we can start setting up the cables as well. So often you'll have a couple of extra cables that you're not actually going to need for the build. So what I usually do is I just identify all the cables I'm going to be using. So this cable here is for our CPU power. So this one I always like to route up the top here. And most cases have a hole here that you can just place it through. So it's nice and neat. And the CPU power on the other side is near this corner as well. So when I turn it around, you'll see what I mean. For the 24-pin power, this is this one. It's the largest connector. Usually I put it in the middle of the top hole. For this case, I think I'm gonna put it in the top. And then, yeah, when I turn it around, I'll show you where it goes. So I kind of just pre-route it like this. So this cable here is for PCI Express graphics cards. The particular one in today's video, we don't need this power because it draws it all from the motherboard itself. But for higher end, more powerful graphics cards, we often need to use these. These are two 6+2 pin PCI Express power connections. This is two SATAs and a Molex. We don't need a Molex, but we do need two SATAs, so I might use this cable, but I'll just check these other ones. Yeah, I won't use this cable. This actually has a connection for a floppy drive as well. Okay, so now with this SATA connection, I'm just gonna connect to the front ARGB lighting. And then for this other connection, I need it for the SSD. For the SSD, I'm using the Crucial BX500, and it's a pretty great SSD. I actually have one of these personally at home myself, and I use it for video games, and it's been really good so far. So I'm gonna install the SSD in the hard drive bay because it looks the cleanest. So you just have to align the four screw holes on the bottom of the SSD with this hard drive cage, like this. So once you get four of these screws, just pretty much screw it into place. Once you've screwed all the screws in, all you need to do is align it back with the hard drive cage. And then just slide it into place. Now, you have the two connections at the back. You've got the SATA power connection here, and then you've got the SATA data. The SATA data cable is actually included with the motherboard, and I'll show you what that looks like in a second. So just plug in the power. Okay, so first things first, let's connect the CPU power. So we have an 8-pin connection for CPU power up here. So essentially what I do is I just look for the clip on this side of the connection and then the clip side of the connection on the motherboard, and I just make sure that those match up. You can't really install it wrong anyway because each of these parts have been shaped in a certain way that it won't allow you to make a mistake and put it the wrong way around. So it's pretty much, it's quite straightforward. All right, it's the same story for the 24-pin power. I pretty much just look for the clip here, and then you see the clip side here. And then all you have to do is align it and plug it in. So now we're going to install the graphics card. This is really the most significant part of what makes this a gaming PC. I chose the GALAX GTX 1650EX as it's a great card for 1080p gaming, it's budget friendly, and this one comes pre-overclocked and has dual 80mm fans. So now we're going to install it in the case, and it's pretty straightforward because this one doesn't have any PCI Express power, as I said before. So essentially all we have to do is check where this PCI Express lines up with the back of the case, and we have to remove these slots. So this is a dual slot, so we have to remove the two lower slots. Actually, the two middle slots. We have to remove the two middle slots so that we can install this. So to remove the slots, all we have to do is unscrew the two middle slots. Okay, so these two slots, I'll just take them out. Then just place your graphics card upside down and align it with the slot. We have these cables a little bit in the way, so you just need to pick them up a bit and just move them so you can get in there nice and easily. Just make sure you align the back slots and the PCI Express lane. Once everything's lined up, you can just push it into place. So that's installed now. So all I'm gonna do is just connect the two screws to the slot on the back and just make sure it's nice and secure. So now I'm gonna do a bit of cable management on the back. This is pretty straightforward because there's not that many cables, but usually what I do is I use some cable ties and a pair of side cutters, and I essentially start to group where I want my cables or route them where they look best or neatest. So for example, I tend to put the CPU power here somewhere, and then I might secure it down with a cable tie. I might bunch this up a bit and secure it with a cable tie. I might start to route these all in a line as well to make them nice and neat. And that's essentially the strategy I go with. Everybody's a little bit different, but whatever works for you is what matters. So now with my cable management all complete, I'm going to install the last thing, which is the SATA data cable. I like to leave this last because it's actually quite an easy connection to break, so I don't like to tie it down with zip ties because I'm worried about damaging it. So this cable I kind of just leave sitting freely inside the back of the case. So what I do is I just make sure it aligns and matches up with the cable. So it needs to go this way. And then you just plug it in and it has a little click when it's in place. Like that. And then I basically just route it where it goes on the motherboard. So it's usually near the bottom right. And that's pretty much the build complete. All we have to do is now just put on these side panels. And then you can pop it in here. So now the PC is finished. What I tend to do is just plug it in and then turn it on. And I just check that, you know, all the lights come on, and inside the case, I check that all the fans are on, and that's a pretty good indication that everything's okay. Now, if you think it's a bit dark inside, I personally agree. And what I would do is buy some RGB or ARGB fans for the front, because you can put three in the front here. And you could put some up the top as well, but I don't think it's really necessary. And then you could also buy some strip lights, so you could pop one here and here. And all these kind of things are pretty cheap. You know, fans are what, $20-$30, and then you got the strip lights, about $30 for a set. So you could really light it up if you want to, but again, it's a personal preference thing, and if you're happy to have it nice and stealthy like this, then that's all good too. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to buy the parts in today's video and build a budget gaming PC of your own, then please check out the links below. Thanks for watching, and as always, I'll catch you guys again in the next video.